कुंज विभाजी जय राधा माधव कुंज विभाजी जगति जनवालभ गिरिवर धारी जय मुक्ति जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी जय यशोदनंदन जय ब्रज जनरंजन जय यशोदनंदन जय ब्रज जनरंजन यमुना तीरवन चारी जय कुंज बिहारी
माताजी यू कैन टेक सम वाटर आई विल कंटिन्यू जय राधा माधव
ओके थैंक यू
जय राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी जय गोपी जन वल्लभ जय गिरिवर धारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चारी जय राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे थैंक यू माताजी फॉर द टाइम एंड एसोसिएशन टुडे आई विल जस्ट शेयर द स्क्रीन माताजी इज गोइंग टू इनलाइट अस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ भागवत श्रीमद भगवद गीता चैप्टर 18 वर्स 65 आई विल शेयर द स्क्रीन माताजी
थैंक यू My humble obeisances to all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha, Kripa Sindhubhyayavacha, Paditanam Pavanibhyo, Vaishnavibhyo, Namo Namaha. I humbly request you to please give me your blessings and your mercy that I'm able to do this service for you by the empowerment of Vaishnavas and Guru Maharaj and Srila Prabhupada and Lord Chaitanya. Then only we can do anything. So I humbly request you to give me your blessings. So we are going to read this beautiful verse because try as I might, I cannot get away from eulogizing my dear godbrother Janaki Nath. And I want to do that. It's not that I'm trying to get away. I want to do this. He's been in my thoughts. He's been in my chanting. He's been in my prayers. He's been in my supplication, begging him to give us all his mercy. And to me, this verse is again very significant of the life that Janakinath Prabhu led. So I have chosen this verse in glorification of him. And also as a reminder that this is actually the way we should also go. So I would like to read this verse and speak a little bit by mercy of Guru and Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेष्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तमा श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी. Bhagavad Gita, chapter 18, which is the final chapter called Conclusion, the perfection of renunciation. And we are choosing verse number 65, which goes like this. And you're welcome to say it along with me. Manmana bhava madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mam eva ishyasi satyam te pratijane priyasimi. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Always think of me, become my devotee, worship me, and offer your homage unto me. Thus you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. Purport. The most confidential part of knowledge is that one should become a pure devotee of Krishna and always think of him and act for him. One should not become an official meditator. Life should be so molded that one will always have the chance to think of Krishna. One should always act in such a way that all his daily activities are in connection with Krishna. He should arrange his life in such a way that throughout the 24 hours, he cannot think of Krishna. And the Lord's promise is that anyone who is in such pure Krishna consciousness will certainly return to the abode of Krishna, where he will be engaged in the association of Krishna face to face. This most confidential part of knowledge is spoken to Arjuna because he is a dear friend of Krishna. Everyone who follows the path of Arjuna can become a dear friend to Krishna and obtain the same perfection as Arjuna. These words stress that one should concentrate his mind upon Krishna, the very form. With two hands carrying a flute, the bluish boy with a beautiful face and peacock feathers in his hair. There are descriptions of Krishna found in the Brahma Samhita and other literatures. One should fix his mind on this original form of Godhead, Krishna. One should not even divert his attention to other forms of the Lord. The Lord has multi forms as Vishnu, Narayan, Ram, Varaha, etc. But a devotee should concentrate his mind on the form that was present before Arjuna. Concentration of the mind on the form of Krishna constitutes the most confidential part of knowledge, and this is disclosed to Arjuna because Arjuna is the most dear friend of Krishna's. Om Agnanatimirandasya Gnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunvilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदामयं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्. So this is a very beautiful instruction in the final chapter of the Bhagavad Gita that Krishna is speaking to Arjuna. And what does he say? This is the process of devotional service, and you do these four things, and because you will be doing these four things, I promise you, you will come back to me. So see how much assurance Krishna is giving to Arjuna by speaking these words. And then he's, through instructing Arjuna, Krishna is instructing all of us. And what is that? Always think of me, become my devotee, worship me, and offer your homage unto me. Thus, you will come back to me without fail. For I promise you this, because you are my very dear friend. So this is Krishna's promise. He's not just saying it. You know, in this material world, we say, yes, yes, I promise. And then after 2 days, we say, well, I don't know. I know I said it, but this, that. Krishna is not like that. When he makes a promise, he keeps his word. So we can take great courage. We can take great heart from the statement of Krishna that if we do these four things, as Janakinath Prabhu did, we will go back to Krishna. And Srila Prabhupada also gives this reassurance. He says, you will see Krishna face to face. This is the promise that Srila Prabhupada also said. So we can take a lot of courage from the words of the Gita, from the words of Srila Prabhupada, from the words of our Guru Maharaj, from the words of the Acharyas, and mold our life in such a way that we will always be thinking of Krishna. All the time, Krishna. Worship Krishna, bhajo Krishna, bolo Krishna, karo Krishna shiksha. Always think of Krishna. Always remember Krishna. Always worship Krishna. Always glorify Krishna. Do everything as a service to Krishna. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer, whatever you give away, whatever austerities you perform, do that, O son of Kunti, as an offering unto me. What is that term? I'm saying the English translation of yad karoshi. Yes. Yad karoshi yad ashnashi yad juhoshi dadasi yad yad tapasyasi kaunteya tad kurushva madarpanam. So Krishna is saying, all our activities, do it as a service to me. So we are involved in so many activities. Somebody is driving a car for a living. Somebody is running a shop. Somebody is a teacher. Somebody is a homemaker. Somebody is a mother. Somebody is a father. You're doing so many duties and so many different roles. You might say, how am I supposed to be a devotee? Well, Krishna gives the formula. Do everything as a service to me. You may be a doctor. You may be an engineer. You may be a chartered accountant. You may be a lawyer. You may be CPA, you may be anything, it doesn't matter. Everything can be done in such a way that we're always trying to please Krishna. You may be combing your child's hair, you may be checking their homework, you may be preparing a quick snack for your kiddo. So what? Everything can be done with that mood of, I am serving Krishna's child, I'm serving Krishna's devotee. It may be your mother, it may be your father, it may be your husband, it may be your relatives, it may be your neighbors, it may be your students. Whatever the situation and whatever role we are playing, if we are constantly meditating, how can I do this to serve Krishna? How can I do this nicely to please Krishna? Then automatically, dadami buddhi yogam tam. Krishna says, I will give you intelligence. So we can see how Janakinath Prabhu had perfected this. In every situation, completely dependent on Krishna, taking direct guidance from Krishna, coming up with creative solutions to difficult situations, and always smiling through the whole thing. Always. Unflappable. Nothing would get him into a tizzy. He wouldn't become frantic or annoyed or upset or frustrated or this or that. He would smilingly depend on Krishna and wait for Krishna to give him that intelligence and just carry on with that plan that Krishna gave him. So this is the quality of a very elevated personality who is able to continue with topmost service no matter how difficult the circumstance. Of course, we are very, very small and tiny. We cannot jump to that level, but we can take courage from seeing these great devotees and from praying for their mercy that we may also become one day by their mercy in that position where we are rendering pure, unmotivated, uninterrupted service. Ahaituki apratihata. We are completely absorbed and we have reached that point where nothing and no one and whatever the circumstances, we're simply serving Krishna. So this is the way one should act. Krishna is saying over here, don't become an official meditator. That means, you know, I'm with my bees and okay, I'm done. Okay, next, what next, what next? What? Actually, this is actually more, at least speaking of myself, you know, we are very much in the mode of passion. We are doing our to-do list and we are checking off, you know, this is to be done, that is to be done, that is to be done, that is to be done. And we're just going through the motions, but the consciousness with which we are doing it is very different from the consciousness of one who has become pure. So we want to reach that point. We should always be thinking of Krishna, arrange our life in such a way that we are thinking 24 hours of Krishna, become the devotee of Krishna, worship Krishna, offer homage to Krishna. And then what happens? Krishna fulfills his promise. He takes us back to the holy abode of his beautiful land called Golok Vrindavan, where this enchanting blue boy with a peacock feather in his hair is playing his transcendental flute, surrounded by all the gopas and having a wonderful time. That is actually the place of real enjoyment. If you really want to enjoy, we should go back to the spiritual world. That is where real enjoyment. And what is that enjoyment? It is not a selfish enjoyment. It is the enjoyment of serving Krishna in pure love, which is the highest enjoyment actually. So we want to become situated like that, and we want to mold our life in such a way. So what is the formula for that? Formula is to follow this path. This most confidential knowledge is spoken to Arjun because he's a dear friend of Krishna. Su sukham kartum avyayam. Krishna says, I'm giving you this most confidential knowledge. And then Krishna says, this is joyfully performed. If you think of Janakinath, you cannot help but smile. If you think of Janakinath, you see a bundle of energy, you know, rushing around, full of light, full of joy, full of happiness, full of the desire to serve, to uplift, to encourage, to enthuse, to just bring more and more of their Krishna consciousness, which is inside them, more to the surface. Pure selfless service. So we want to become like Janakinath. We want to become pure-hearted. Now, what is that process of becoming pure-hearted? Cheto darpanam arjanam. And how is that happening? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. As one of the people was saying yesterday and day before in his memories, what did Janakinath write on that little book he gave as a gift? 99% of our spiritual advancement comes from our chanting. So we must focus on making our chanting purer and purer and purer and free of offenses. Actually, if we do this one thing, the 11th offense is being inattentive to the holy name. If we just focus on making our chanting more effective, more attentive, more focused, more prayerful, more pleading and begging to Krishna for his mercy, then Krishna in our heart, seeing our pure desire, will cleanse us of all desires for material enjoyment, all material attachments, all fruitive desires. Because the desire for fruitive activities is very deep-rooted in our system. It's very hard to get it out. Whoever heard of just doing things to please God? No, I have to get something out of it, isn't it? In this world, we are always looking to see, what can I get out of this? If I do this, what will I get? What's in it for me? This is the mentality which keeps us caught in fruitive activities. But bhakti is above all this. Bhakti doesn't care what comes back. Bhakti is only desiring to give, which is Janakinath Prabhu. He was only giving, 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 giving love, giving care, giving concern, giving upliftment, giving encouragement to others. That's all I can remember of Janakinath, that he was always in the mood of giving. So we want that we also reach this point of pure devotional service, because this is actually who we really are. Our real nature is to be pure, loving servants of Krishna, eternal, full of knowledge, full of bliss, Sat-Chit Ananda. And how will this happen? By constantly remembering Krishna. Krishna becomes pleased towards the devotee who is engaged in his service with great sincerity and devotion. So, Vedaischa Sarvai Aham Eva Vedyaha. From me come remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness. By all the Vedas, I am to be known. Indeed, I am the compiler of the Vedantas and the knower of the Vedas. So Krishna is saying, if you want to remember me, I will give you the chance to remember me. If you want to forget me, I will give you the chance to forget me. From me, everything comes. So we want to turn our face more and more towards Krishna and not away from Krishna. We want to remember Krishna. We want to serve Krishna. And we want to follow the path of the great Mahajans. Mahajano Jena Gata Sapantha. Follow in the path. Follow in the footsteps of the great devotees. And then Krishna says, which form should we meditate on? The very form, carrying a flute, bluish boy with a beautiful face and peacock feathers in his hair. Govindam adi purusham tamaham vajami. We sing that, isn't it? In the morning, velum kvanantam aravinda dalaya taksham. Aravinda dalaya taksham, beautiful eyes. And aravinda dalaya taksham, varhavatam sam asitam buddha sundaramgam. Kandarp koti kaminiya vishesha shobham govindam adi purusham tamaham vajami. I worship Krishna, who is decked, who has a beautiful peacock feather in his hair, holding his transcendental flute, his bluish body, the color of rain clouds. What a beautiful picture comes in the mind when we just hear these beautiful prayers of Brahma Samhita. And all these descriptions, why they are there? To glorify Krishna and to give us an understanding, who is Krishna? What does he look like? Who are his companions? What does he like to eat? How does he like to play? What mischief he likes to do? Krishna is a naughty little boy. He does lots of mischief. Did you know that? He does many, many mischievous things in Vrindavan. And one of the mischievous things, there's a beautiful song in Kannada which goes like this. I'm remembering my childhood days now. Mela mela ne bandani gopamma ki le mela ne bandani. The meaning of the song is Mella Melane Bandhu Gallige Muddukottu. Very stealthily, very naughtily, very mischievously, this little boy Krishna, one gopi is telling another gopi, you know what he did? He came up to me, he gave me a kiss on my cheek, and then he ran away. This is what little boys do, isn't it? They do mischief and then they run away, hiding. Mommy will catch me, mommy will beat me, mommy will chastise me. So, but the gopis are so enchanted by his beauty, by his mischief, by his naughtiness, by his charm, by his antics, by his flute, by everything. Krishna is all enchanting. And we can become totally enchanted with Krishna too. How? By hearing about him, by listening to his glorification, by engaging in the process of devotional service, by coming together. Janakinath Prabhu brought everyone together. Why? To glorify Krishna, to remember Krishna, to serve Krishna. So we want to be like that. We want to be immersed in Krishna consciousness. We want to be enchanted by Krishna because he's enchanting. He's all attractive. That's the meaning of Krishna. So how do we fix our mind on this form of Krishna? We should remember Krishna. We should see the deity form of the Lord every day. And we should keep that like a photographic picture. You take a picture in your mind and you keep thinking about that beautiful form of the Lord. What else is there to look at? Who else is there to think about anyway? It all pales in comparison. When we think of things of this material world, it becomes stale, pale, dry, not, you know, there's no rasa in it. But when you think of Krishna, everything becomes very wonderful, isn't it? And Janakinath Prabhu was the epitome of this. He would rush around, buzz around, jump around, dance around, sing and do everything, joke around. Why? He was jolly. Srila Prabhupada says, spiritual life means jolly. Susukham kartum avyayam. What is that term? Ninth chapter of Gita, verse number 2. Rajavidya Rajaguyam. Pavitram idamuttamam pratyekshavagamam dharmam susukham kartumavyayam. This knowledge is the king of knowledge, the most secret of all secrets. And because it gives perfect knowledge of the self by self-realization, it is the topmost of all religion. It is joyfully performed. It's eternal. It's eternal. This is who we really are. There's nothing and nothing else but our eternal identity as servants of Krishna. I am not Brahmana, I am not Vaishya, I am not Kshatriya, I am not Shudra, I am not Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, so on and so forth. Who am I? Eternal servant of Krishna. So Janakinath had perfected that. We may just remember it from time to time. Like now I'm just remembering all this because I'm really preaching to myself here. I'm remembering all this. Why? Because I'm giving class. But rest of the time, what am I thinking of? My this, my that, my bills, my But Janakinath had risen above all that. He was totally on the transcendental platform because he was completely devoted to the service of Guru and Krishna. And his only desire, especially in the last stages, was somehow or the other to give Krishna to others. Even in the most trying and most difficult circumstances, he simply wanted to give Krishna. And I remember Guru Maharaj writing to me, the best way to get Krishna is to give Krishna to others. This is how we get Krishna. So we want to do the same things so that we can also perfect our life. We can also concentrate on the beautiful form of Krishna, worship Krishna, remember Krishna, glorify Krishna, tushyanti cha ramanti cha. You know, the Bhagavad Gita 10.9, it goes like this. The thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me. Their lives are devoted to my service and they derive great satisfaction and bliss by always conversing about me and enlightening one another about me. Machita matgat prana bodhayantascha parasparam katayantascha mam nityam tushyanti cha ramanti cha. So here is the delight, here is the happiness, here is the pleasure. What is that? Discussing Krishna, talking about Krishna, glorifying Krishna, serving Krishna. As this verse says, it's all about Krishna. Everything Krishna. So our desires should be molded. Our lives should be molded. Until our thoughts, our words, our deeds, everything becomes aligned with the mission of Krishna. And what is the mission of Krishna in this age of Kali, dear brothers and sisters? It is to uplift everyone to the spiritual abode. How? Harinam Sankirtan, giving the holy name, encouraging people to become pure, give up all bad habits. Don't do this drinking and smoking and drugging and, you know, all these, because they are all self-destructive anyway. They're not good for you anyway. Take to this joyful process, make your life happy and successful, and then help others. Janma sartak kari karo paropkar. Bharat Bhumite Manushya Janma Hoylo Ja Janma Sarthak Kari Karo Para Upkar. That means you make your life successful and help others make their life successful. Lord Chaitanya says this in Chaitanya Charitamrita, especially those born in the holy land of India. Bharat Bhumite Manushya Janma Hoylo Ja, those who have taken human form of life in the holy land of Bharat, you make your life successful and then help others make their life successful. So Krishna is wanting what? All of us come back to him. All of us get out of the cycle of birth and death. He doesn't want to see us suffering in this material world. We don't want to go back to Krishna, but Krishna wants us to come back to him. This is the predicament. You know, we are like that. I don't know, sometimes you may see, you know, a little insect is caught, you know, in a little pool of water, and you're trying to put a little leaf to save that little insect. And, you know, he's so frightened, he's just moving away from the very thing that will save his life. So we are like that. The very thing that will save us, we're trying to move away from that. Why? Because of our conditioning. We want to overcome this conditioning, which has only brought what? Repeated birth, repeated death. Repeated birth, repeated death. And, you know, you may say, oh, well, you know, next lifetime, you know. But look at the world around us. Look at what is going on around us. Is it really going to be any better? No, it's actually getting worse. Day by day, Kali is progressing and the situation is actually becoming more and more dangerous. Even for devotees to practice Krishna consciousness will become more and more difficult as time goes, because the forces against godly people are increasing. The demoniac forces are also increasing. Of course, devotees will also increase, but it is going to become more and more challenging as time goes. So why waste time? Why not perfect our life in this very lifetime, like Janakinath Prabhu did, and go back home to Krishna? That is our real home anyway. This is only a place of misery. Dukkhalayam ashashvatam. So we want to remember Krishna. Why? Because yam yam vapi smaran bhavam. Whatever you remember, Bhagavad Gita 8.5 and 8.6. And whatever thoughts you have at the time of death, that state you will attain without fail, O son of Kunti. Krishna is saying this. So this is actually a very, very instructive verse. And it's also, like you can say, summum bonum, you know, of all the instructions that Krishna has given so far. And then the most important verse comes right after this verse. What is that? Abandon all varieties of religion. Just surrender unto me. I will deliver you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear. Krishna is saying this. Abandon everything else. Just surrender unto me. Come into my shelter and I will give you all protection. Do not worry. God is assuring us. Who is he who is assuring us? It is God Almighty, the Supreme Absolute Truth, God of all gods. The Supreme Lord Krishna, who is giving us this assurance that you will come back to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. How much love is there in this verse? How much promise is there in this verse? So let us all take courage from the great example that Janakinath Prabhu has set for us with his exemplary life, with his unbelievable devotion to Guru and Krishna, with his personal character showing us how to be with other people. I mean, personally speaking, I have so much to learn from Janakinath Prabhu. I have so much to imbibe from his way of functioning, from his way of being with devotees, from his way of being with non-devotees, from his way of conducting himself in all circumstances. His creativity, his outside-the-box thinking, is just unbelievable how many good qualities Krishna had put in just one person. So I want to glorify, I think I'll never stop glorifying Janakinath Prabhu. I think this is something I'm going to be doing all the time. Because Janakinath is Janakinath, very special, extraordinary. And Krishna says this in the very last verse of the Gita. What does Krishna say? Wherever there's Krishna, the master, the supreme archer, wherever there's Krishna, the master of mystics, and wherever there's Arjuna, the supreme archer, there will be opulence, victory, extraordinary power, and morality. This is my opinion. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, Tatra Partha Dhanurdhara, Tatra Shirir Vijayo Bhutir, Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. There will be opulence, there will be victory, there will be extraordinary power and morality. So our Janakinath, you know, our supreme archer, you know, he has aimed for the lotus feet of Krishna. Boom, he has gone there. The supreme archer, like Arjuna, he has attained perfection. Why? Because his aim was one-pointed, how to please Guru and Krishna. Bas, finish, nothing else, like this, one-pointed aim. So we have a lot to learn from Janakinath. We have many, many lessons. We have many, many layers to uncover, to reach that point of pure devotional service. But we have a living example now in Janakinath, who will live forever in our hearts, who will always be there to guide us and to help us by his own example of how to make it back to Krishna. So thank you very much for listening very patiently and tolerating me. I hope I have done justice to the service that was asked of me. Please forgive me if I've disappointed you in some way. And let us open up for discussion, comments, questions, realizations, corrections. My humble obeisances to all of you. Jai Srila Prabhupada, Jai Guru Maharaj, Jai Janakinath Prabhu Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna Mataji, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada and Gurudev.
Please accept mine. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to our Gurudev.
Thank you so much, Mataji, for giving a class spontaneously. It was very nice, and thank you for choosing this beautiful verse. I request devotees, if there are comments, realizations, questions, please go ahead. There is a question in the chat, Mataji, by Dheeraj. Dheeraj Prabhu is asking, can we take pride in being a devotee of Krishna and chanting his holy names compared to others who are not?
Dheeraj Prabhu, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Prabhupada, all glories to Gurudev. Srila Prabhupada said this, the only pride a devotee is allowed is, I am a servant of Krishna. That is the only pride a devotee is allowed. But we don't compare ourselves to others and, think that we are superior or better. We certainly consider ourselves very fortunate. And then we try to uplift others who may not have received that fortune yet, because we don't know who they are. Maybe after they get the holy name, they will just zoom past us and, we'll be looking and wondering what happened. He joined 5 years after me and he's gone 15 years ahead of me. Like, look at Janakinath Prabhu, Boom, he came and then zoom, he went to a very, very high level, way past people who are practicing 30, 40, 50 years. So we don't know who the people who are not chanting right now may be in the future. They may be very elevated souls, and the moment they take to Krishna, they may just be, connecting with their previous devotional service, which may already be at a very elevated level, and they may reach exalted position. So we cannot really look at someone and say, oh, he or she is not chanting, so they're not a devotee, or they're not as good as me or something like that, because everyone ultimately is a potential devotee. They just don't know it yet. As George Harrison says in the Introduction to Krishna book, everyone is looking for Krishna. They need Krishna. They don't know it, but they are all searching for Krishna. And when they find Krishna, who knows where they will go with that? So it's always best for us to remember who we really are. Who are we really? We are just tiny little ants, and we don't have much knowledge or, qualifications or anything. So our best bet to be safe is to be Trina, the peace, Nichena, Taro, Rivasa, Hishnuna, Amanina, Manadena, Kirtaniya, Sadahari. One should chant the holy name of the Lord in a humble state of mind, thinking oneself lower than the straw in the street. One should be more tolerant than a tree, completely devoid of false prestige, and ready to offer all respects to others. So actually, who is, everybody is a temple of Krishna, because Krishna is there in everyone's heart. Devotee, non-devotee is a temporary designation. In moments, they can become a devotee, and the devotee may turn away from Krishna and become non-devotee. So who can say this, So we must always try to see that this person has Krishna in them. Whether they're devotee or non-devotee really doesn't matter. We offer our humble obeisances to everyone, offer great respects to everyone, because that person is ultimately a child of God, child of Krishna, no matter what their external designation. I hope that's satisfactory. And if someone else would like to add, we have many devotees online.
Thank you so much, Mataji. Thank you,
Dheeraj Prabhu. But we also have many devotees online who might like to help you with this question. Please feel free to unmute and please share your thoughts so that our little godbrother Dheeraj Prabhu will get more and more nectar. Please add if you would like to. Don't feel shy. Radha Vinodini, Vishnupriya, Susanna, Agne, Ivana, we have so many people. Vishalini Madhiji, would you like to say something? Well, nobody is saying anything. Dheeraj Prabhu, was that satisfactory? You're welcome to ask Guru Maharaj tomorrow. And that will be the perfect answer you will get. Okay, we see that Raj Prabhu has raised his hand. Is that right? Raj Prabhu, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna. Congratulations. All glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to Guru Maharaj, all glories to Adiya Jankinath Prabhu, all glories to Mataji. I'd like to say thank you for that wonderful class. It was so joyful and full of energy, truly in the spirit of Adiya Jankinath Prabhu. I wanted to ask a question, if I may. It's at the moment, it's very easy to be fully absorbed in memories of Jankinath Prabhu and in trying to figure out how we apply the life lessons from his example. And it's also easy when things are happening all the time that I can think, what would Jankinath Prabhu want me to do? What would he do? That's what I have to do. And it's wonderful, absolutely wonderful. But my fear is that will I still be able to remember him as well? Will I still be able to follow him after time has passed? I don't want this feeling to ever end, and I'm scared that, like, maybe in a week, a month, I don't know how long, I don't want it to wear off. Very, and I don't know if you can advise anything.
Yeah, this is a very important point you have raised, actually, because the best way to honor a Vaishnava is to follow in their footsteps, is to honor the legacy that they have left behind. And so the best way to remember Janakinath, the best way to glorify him, is to always try to remember how he would do things and how he would apply himself wholeheartedly to the situation and how he would harness, you know, supernatural powers, I don't know from where he got them, obviously from Krishna, to make things happen in such a way that everyone is uplifted. So this is going to have to be our daily meditation, or hour meditation, or moment-to-moment meditation. It's something that we are going to have to work at. Because the mind is, you know, so chanchal, and it is so unreliable, it will take you in all so many different directions. So constantly remembering the great souls, this is one way we can stay on track. I encourage you, you know, I'll give you a little tip. I don't know if this will be useful. Feel free to accept or reject it. It's up to you entirely. But Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj would write a letter every day to Srila Prabhupada. He would write, you know, his thoughts, his desires, his services, his maybe even mistakes. I don't know. I'm not privy to that. But every day he would write a letter in which he expressed his desire to get better, to get better, to get better, to get perfect. He would pray like that. So we can all write a letter every day to Janakinath Prabhu, to, you know, him asking, you know, this is what I did. What is your suggestion? How would you like me to do this? And, you know, great souls, they are interested in uplifting us. They will help us. They will give us guidance. They will be there for us. It's on the spirit level, anything is possible. On the spirit level, anything is possible. So don't ever, I don't know whether I should say this, but maybe I should, as a way to encourage you that we have not lost Janakinath. He can come anywhere, anytime. So I'll share. Okay, I'll share this. I did share it with Guru Maharaj and a few of my god sisters. This happened right after Janakinath Prabhu's, situation became very gravely ill. It was just the day after Ekadashi. On that Ekadashi day, I was chanting. I was praying. I chanted many, many extra rounds for him. And next day, Dwadashi morning, I was chanting again. And I was just meditating, you know, and praying to the Lord. And guess who comes in my consciousness? Janakinath. And Janakinath says, with a big smile, he waves like this. And he says, goodbye, Sri Devi. I love you. And he blew me a kiss like this. I was so startled. And before I could react, before I could respond, he was gone. Why I'm saying this is to reassure you that on the spirit level, we are always united. So if you pray to him, if you think of him, he will be there for you. Is that helpful?
That's wonderful. Thank you so much.
Yes, the great souls always want to continue their service, and he will not stop his service. He will continue to try to uplift all of us and take us back to Godhead. So don't worry. Keep pictures of him everywhere. Write down little, you know, anecdotes that you remember about him. Keep a little diary, you know, just Janakinath diary. As you listen to what people are saying about him, write those things down. There are so many wonderful, you know, memories that are coming up. And try to see, Janakinath, you are my mentor. You are my spiritual guide. You are my spiritual master. You know, he's our Shiksha Guru in many ways. You know, please guide me and help me. Because remember, the relationship is eternal. Our masters never leave us. They are eternally connected to them. That is how life after life we promise, I want to serve you. How is that? Because on the spirit level, there are no limitations. Anything can happen. Is that helpful?
That's absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much.
Okay. Glad to have some service to you, Raj Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
We have
Vishnu Priya Mataji has raised her.
Yes, Vishnu Priya Mataji. Please go ahead, Vishnu Priya Mataji. My humble obeisances to you. All glories to Prabhupada. All glories to Gurudev.
Hare Krishna, my dear sister. Pranams to you. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to our dear Gurudev. So I just, first of all, I want really to thank you for this wonderful lecture. You are so brave just to grab this opportunity to give lecture. Wonderful. And you gave also very wonderful answer to Raj Prabhu. I was just thinking to add two things maybe which could be important for him, if you will allow me.
Oh, certainly, greatly, and it'll be helpful to me too. Please share.
So I think that what would be very important is to stay in contact with those who are connected with him, with Janakinath, and who will always have faith to discuss his glories. So this would be first proposal from my side. And second one is, devotees likes to make Udipanis on holy dham in their home. And then wherever they turn, they can see Radha Krishna's photos, Giriraj Govardhan photo, or Radha Kund and Shyama Kund, or Krishna Balaram, something like this. So I think that we can do same with our God brother. We can also put his photo. We can regularly, at least, I don't know, maybe one time per month, offer some garland to him. Or just maybe in Raj Prabhu's situation. I think he is in London, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe to try to get some maha. I'm already on the way. I don't know if I will be successful. But maybe just to try to get some maha, some orange piece of cloth which was belonging to him, and to keep him all the time present in front of the eyes. So this is what I'm planning to do. And I wanted to share with Raj Prabhu and with others. Maybe this will be also small inspiration for others. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishnu Priya. You had a lot of association with Janakinath and a lot of services together. So you have many, many memories and many wonderful things to share about Janakinath. So Raj Prabhu, I encourage you to keep in touch with Vishnu Priya Mataji.
Thank you.
Maybe, you know, as Vishnu Priya Mataji said, maybe once a month, just have a little get together in your home. Say on this one day in the month, you know, once in 30 days, or maybe once in 2 months, whatever you choose, you know, 6 times a year or 12 times a year, we'll all come together to remember Janakinath, to glorify Janakinath, to pray to him to guide us and lead us forward in his various sevas that he started. So maybe you can have a sangha like that. Janakinath, Prabhu, Sadhu Sangha, Group Ki Jai. Jai. Thank you, Vishnu Priya. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you, Sri Devi. Thank you.
When you get a piece of Maha, save something for me.
Well, I will try. This will be difficult, but I will give my best.
Okay.
I hope that something will come into my direction. This was a joke. I will very happily share with you.
Okay.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. Sudha Mataji has raised hand. Mataji, please go ahead.
Thank you, Mataji. Yeah, Hare Krishna. Dhanu Pranam, Mataji. Please accept my humble obeisances. Yeah, thank you, Mataji.
It's a mine. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to Gurudev.
Yeah, thank you, Mataji. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to Gurudev. All glories to Chaitanya Prabhuji. Thank you, Mataji, for the very wonderful class. And thank you for telling the importance, like how important to like always think of Krishna, worship Krishna and become devotee of Krishna. I just wanted to share like last few days, listening to Janakinath Prabhuji glories, I felt so much inspired, I realized so many things, we've been reading scriptures, but I felt like, while listening to Prabhuji's glories, it's more how to apply practically, these scriptures, how to apply Krishna consciousness. Realized by listening to Janakinath Prabhuji's glories, so much good qualities, like his non-envious, he's always approachable. And how he's so humble and joyful and always has a deep desire to serve Krishna and his embodiment, serving Guru Maharaj. So many qualities. I feel like I was meditating on Janakinath Prabhuji's glories. Thank you. I mean, it really felt like I learned so much and have a desire to imbibe these qualities. And by the mercy of Janakinath Prabhuji and also Guru Maharaj, may I also imbibe these qualities and become a nice devotee of Krishna. So I just wanted to share, and I really like today's point, following the path of self-realized souls is very important. So may I also follow the realized souls Janakinath Prabhuji and become a nice devotee. I just wanted to share this, Mataji. And thank you so much for your wonderful, very nice class.
Thank you very much for sharing your realizations, Sudha Mataji. Thank you for encouraging me in my seva, even though it's not very elevated or very learned or anything like that. You are kindly overlooking my faults and encouraging me. Thank you so much.
No, Mataji, thank you so much, Mataji. I'm learning so much from your lectures. I'm still a very neophyte level. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Me too. Me too. Me too. I have a long ways to go, believe me.
Thank you, Sudha Mataji. Is there anyone else who would like to share realizations or ask questions? I think no one has anything to share. So, Mataji, with your permission, shall we end the call?
Yes, certainly. So, I'm happy that you hosted us. Thank you so much for kindly hosting us. Sorry for being a little distracted. I did not notice your messages or anything.
No problem, Mataji.
A little taken by surprise, but that's okay. Krishna testing us all the time.
Thank you for the opportunity to serve, Mataji. And thank you once again for your nice class, your time, your association. And thank you to your devotees for joining in. I would like to pay my obeisances. Vanchakal Putarubhyacha, Kripa Sindhubha Evacha, Patitanam Pavanepyo, Vaishnavepyo Namo Namaha, Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Guru Maharaj Ki Jai, Hare Krishna Shri Devi Mataji Ki Jai.
Janakinath
Prabhu Ki Jai.
Guru Maharaj Ki Jai.
Jai. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Wonderful class. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Dhiraj Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Radha Vinodini.
I will end the call, Mataji. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Just a quick question for Dhiraj Prabhu. Dhiraj Prabhu, are you completely well now? Are you back home? Okay. No worries. I'll contact him separately. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.